Who were the people that you remember from Cambridge? Who were your contemporaries? You know, everyone, Oxford and Cambridge in particular, talk about different generations of people who rule the world and do interesting things. But who were the alumni of Cambridge when you were there?
No, they weren't particularly anything. Eric Heaton, who became the principal head of Christchurch, and Peter Baelz, who became Dean of Durham or something, you know. But it was interesting. He was a philosopher, and I mean they were interesting. They were very interesting. I don't know if they were famous. They were just interesting.
You said religion. A lot of people were interested in religion.
Yes, they were.
Were you wrestling with your own personal religion at that time?
Oh, very much, because I was a Jew and I was very much wrestling with it, yes. We were not very religious in the family, but we went every year to, you know, Day of Atonement and this sort of things. And it was out there for me. It wasn't real enough. It was too abstracted. The Jewish religion was too abstracted for me. I really wanted something more you could get hold of. So I was very much for being a Christian, very much for Christianity, because I felt it had a real something you could get hold of and something that related to my life. You know, I think my parents, my father in particular, you know, didn't. He always said, "I have my own religion," but he did. He did. You know, he did do the Jewish thing, but I always felt in a way that the Jewish thing was so much to do with history, ancestry, the whole that, and it wasn't enough to do with me.
So do you have religious beliefs now?
I don't go to any religious things. If we near the chapel at St. Alden's Head when we down in the country, and you know, and it's a religious day, like a Christmas, or sometimes on Sunday, Sheila said, "Should we go?" Yeah, I'll go. I don't enjoy it much, but I'll go. I think I believe in God. I find them, the people who are so strongly atheistic are unconvincing to me, not sufficiently convincing to me. But I don't think I believe in a very religious. I don't think I believe the format thing of religion. But I mean, I've been asked to do this church in northern France. I told you about it or not. It was a church that was a plane. It's near Dunkirk, and an English plane went into the roof of it, and the roof caught fire and it was burned down. But not the church was not burned down, and they replaced the roof over the whole church. But the only bit they redid was the nave. So the entire choir has been left as a ruin for 60 years. And they've come to me, I think because they saw my Last Judgment, and I said, "What do you want? What do you want?" And they said, "Whatever you want, whatever you want." I couldn't, because it started like that, it never finishes like that. In the end, you know, everybody gets a say in the Monument Historique and the bishop and the lot. But I'm interested to do that. I would like it to be sort of multi-denominational, but I do think there's a place for people to be able to sit and think and reach into them, into their spiritual side of things. And anyway, I think that in a way, something that Ken Nolan said to me, aren't we all sort of... clergymen manqués, aren't all artists sort of something like, you know? And you once asked me, you said, is sculpture your religion? And I think it is. I think it is. But it's because of an affirmative belief in good. Perhaps not God, good. I mean, do you know there's a wonderful essay by Iris Murdoch called The Supremacy of Good? And it equates God and good.